The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment, love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters, may the Lord give you his peace. Tomorrow's Mother's Day. Any mothers here? We want to honor you. God bless you. Pray for our moms. We want to say hello to all of our friends watching this homily over the internet. Hello, whoever you are out there. If you've been to my masses here, you know I'm constantly talking about a pilgrimage I had the opportunity to make to the Holy Land, to Israel, and what an impact it had on me and anyone else who's been there, seeing these places where the sacred events of the life of Jesus, the things in the Bible, where they happened. And I recently returned from another pilgrimage. I do more than travel on pilgrimages, okay? I had the opportunity to go with a special needs children pilgrimage to Lourdes in France. And as I'm saying this, I'm looking up to the beautiful stained glass window in the choir loft of Our Lady of Lourdes. So beautiful. And wouldn't you know that these two pilgrimages are now kind of united in my mind. And I want to share that with you a little bit. Out of all of the places that I visited in the Holy Land, by far, the place that impacted me more than anywhere else was the tomb of Jesus, that church of the Holy Sepulchre that kind of is over the place where Jesus was buried for 3 days in that tomb. And I'm happy to report that I can say that that tomb is empty. I've seen it. He's not there. It's empty. And so this beautiful season of Easter, of the resurrection that we're in right now, that Jesus is alive. That tomb to this day is still empty. And at the time of Christ, they had a curious practice. They would have a little cave. Where he was buried, his tomb was a little cave. We know from the scriptures that it was a cave that was owned by, who was it, Joseph of Arimathea, and it was recently hewn in the rock and had never been used before. Did you ever wonder what they're talking about? What they would do is they would put the body in this little stone cave, roll a stone in front, and then a year later they would come back and collect the bones. And then the bones would be put in a little box and then buried in like a cemetery. And this cave where Jesus was buried had never been used before. It was recently chipped out of the rock there. And as you're there praying, and I'm thinking about all of the studies I did in the seminary about the resurrection of Jesus, all of those passages from the Bible, and that line from St. Paul, who said that everything that we are, everything that we believe, everything that we hope for, hinges on the resurrection of Jesus. He said, if Jesus did not rise from the dead, we are lost. We are the most idiotic of all people. You know, like, it is the hinge of everything. His death and his resurrection, his triumph over sin, over hatred, over the devil, his victory over death itself. This is our hope. This is our hope. It all hinges on this resurrection of Jesus. And when I was in Lourdes, over in France, you know anything of the story of Lourdes, the visionary Saint Bernadette had the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary there in the 1850s, in this little cave, this little grotto, where it all happened. And I couldn't help but think of the cave of Jesus' tomb as I stood at the cave of Lourdes. And you know the story that in one of the apparitions, the Virgin Mary asked Bernadette, go, drink and wash in the spring. Bernadette was like, what is she talking about? And there was a river just over here, so she went to go to the river. The Virgin Mary said, no, over here. And she directed Bernadette into the cave, little shallow cave, a little grotto, where she started to scratch the dirt and the mud. And this little trickle of water started to come up out of that, the back of the cave. And so when she kind of washed herself with it and tried to drink it, and she had mud all over her face, and people at that point thought, okay, she's crazy, this is not authentic, and what is she doing? And then the water started to flow. And of course, everybody knows that there have been documented miraculous healings from people who have been blessed or bathed or drunk the water that flows from this spring. And I was just there the other day, and I'm here to tell you that that water is still flowing. That water is still flowing. And as I compared the cave of Lourdes to the cave of Jesus' tomb, it hit me like a thunderclap. The symbolism of water is always the symbol of grace, right? And it's like the grace of the Holy Spirit is flowing out of that tomb of Jesus like that spring of living water that brings healing and it brings grace and it brings life. So I believe that's, you know, one of the inner secrets of the meaning of Lourdes. This little cave is symbolic of Jesus' tomb. And as I was praying about that in this beautiful church this evening, I couldn't help but think about the altar. Do you notice how they've decorated the altar here? It looks like a little cave under the altar, doesn't it? With the lilies. Father Kaz, is that symbolic of Jesus' empty tomb? It is. Just got a confirmation from the pastor. And it's at the altar, brothers and sisters, the Eucharist, where the risen Jesus comes to us. His resurrection isn't just something that happened in the past, a curious blip in the history of mankind. It's present and relative today in our lives, and we encounter him when we receive him in the Eucharist. Jesus says, if you receive me, a spring of living water will flow out of your heart. This is what he's talking about. So as we approach the holy altar of God, which tonight looks very much like an empty tomb, we remember the water that's flowing from that little cave in Lourdes, and we remember the grace that is coming to us from that empty tomb of Jesus as we encounter that grace this evening. And may the Lord bless you. Amen.